All right. Welcome back, everybody. Sport Chat 503. Thank you guys very much for watching. First time, long time. Either way, I appreciate it. I'm coming to you live from the coast out here. A little too windy to get out on the outside. It is beautiful. I see beautiful blue skies right there, but man, the wind is ripping today. So let's go ahead and get this in. I have a one shout out to Clifford Robinson, great Blazer, rest in peace. But I have a video every week. Ducks video, college football video, top 25, and Pac-12 video. This is the top 25 video. Love college football. We all do. And we all love to get this in. And again, I really appreciate you guys for watching. If you're Sports Chat fans, then let's do it. I really appreciate that. Let's have some fun. Georgia, obviously, is the team to beat. They're the top dog in the nation coming off a bye week. They've got Florida. Great, great matchup there. Florida's been playing okay, obviously. Florida was very highly ranked early. They bumped down. And this is, we know the drill with Florida, right? We've seen this act before. But I do think Georgia's going to continue to roll. But I love the what-if game. What if, at the end of the year, Bama, Georgia, SEC championship game, Bama beats Georgia? Now we've got the scenario that we were talking about earlier in the season where it's two teams from the SEC in the top four playoff. And it happened this year, or this week, when it came to Alabama jumping Oklahoma, even though Oklahoma's undefeated, Oklahoma continues to win, although barely. The ideology is that it looks like they're going to try to put Bama in already, and it's just the end of week 7 or 8, right? So the ideology is it's bound to happen at some point. Cincinnati with a really close one in the first half. They pull away in the second half, but I don't think anybody's that impressed with the Navy win. No offense to Navy and our armed forces, and the guys who are over there in the armed forces department and those schools are tremendous, but not really necessarily a top two team in the nation would not be struggling with Navy. But that was the case. And Cincinnati found themselves in that situation, and they had to kind of scramble to get out of it. And a one-touchdown win against Navy is something that basically I think was going to move them in the rankings, and it didn't. They held true at 7-0, and I thought that was interesting because obviously we know Oklahoma moved. So Oklahoma's win wasn't good enough, quote unquote, but Cincinnati's was, which was interesting to me because, again, I don't know if they're giving extra favor to Cincinnati, but I would have thought that any suggestion that Cincinnati was not the number two team in the country, Cincinnati would be bumped back. That just was my thought because, again, it feels like Cincinnati might have the chance to win out and put a lot of pressure on this playoff committee to put in the team with the weaker schedule, right? Cincinnati is literally steps away from Alabama. And when it comes to the point total, 14-77 for Cincy, 14-17 for Bama. So you know it's close. Bama with a big win against Tennessee. Bama gets to sit back and relax and rest for a week with the bye week. Again, bye weeks are awesome for these guys because, again, it lets them get healthy, lets the coaches get out and recruit a little bit, lets everybody just kind of take a deep breath, fans take a deep breath. And I think it's really good for the players to kind of recover mentally as well as physically because this season is such a grind. There's so much pressure going on here. Oklahoma, man, this was a game I was actively watching, rooting for Kansas. Wow, what a game, what a game, what a game, man. What could have been, right? And again, this is the argument that people are making out here for Oregon when they had the senior quarterback struggling and you have the freshman that everybody wants to put in. They're like, well, look at Oklahoma. But then all of a sudden, this game here, you know, it felt like Oklahoma was struggled on offense a little bit, especially scoring, you know, only 35 points against a Kansas team that they would normally score, you know, 50 on or whatever with Oklahoma's prowess on offense. So that was a little concerning. It was interesting to watch that game and to kind of see how close Kansas can get, but still be so far away. But it is interesting to see them drop. This is not the first time we've seen them move back, even though they have continued to win. They're sitting there at 8-0. But doesn't look very pretty for them in the future. They got to go play Baylor still at Baylor. They still have to play Oklahoma State at the end of the year. There's still some quality teams in the Big 12. So, and then this week they play Texas Tech. And anything can happen. Obviously, Texas Tech is not the team that they were with Shuck even at the beginning of the year, but Texas Tech is kind of limping through their season. So Oklahoma should get it right. The big one is, though, Ohio State and Michigan. Ohio State and Michigan sitting right there, continuing to win. Big games for both of them, obviously, blowing out Indiana, blowing out Northwestern. And then it leads up to an absolute showdown this week. This is the game where Ohio State gets to play Penn State. We thought this would be like a top 10 matchup or a top 15 matchup with Penn State not holding up to their end of the bargain. They get bumped all the way back to the 20 spot, which is pretty wild to see. But you have this huge matchup between Michigan and Michigan State. Michigan State, the other undefeated team that's actually sandwiched with Oregon in between them. And actually on the way on the outside of that, which I thought was interesting. I thought they would have Ohio State, Michigan, Michigan State right there in a line of five, six, seven. But instead they have Oregon at seven. But this is the week where it's all going to get shown out, right? Because whoever wins this game obviously is going to be bumped back. Somebody's got to win. Somebody's got to lose. If Michigan continues to win, which I think that they will this weekend, puts them in a unique spot going into that Ohio State game if they can continue to win to become one of the greatest of all time if both those teams continue to win. Again, that's a great rivalry that everybody looks forward to watching. And then you have, Michigan State plays Michigan, and then Iowa plays Wisconsin. So you have all these Big Ten schools all packed together so closely. It's amazing to see the power of the Big Ten really in there. Obviously, you know the power of the SEC. It's legitimate, but the top end of the SEC is as good as any team in the country. But that like middle ground to the end of the conference is really questionable. And that's where I feel like the Big Ten has really stepped up their game. They're pretty consistent across the board. Not many days off. And that's kind of how I think the Pac-12 is trying to be. And then you have Ole Miss sitting there with one loss, who will continue to play well, beat LSU. I don't know what to make of LSU. One week they play well, it's going to be a train wreck the rest of the way. But Ole Miss has Auburn. That's a huge matchup. That should be another one of those great SEC on CBS games. We said Notre Dame, they've got North Carolina. North Carolina was a team people really thought was going to be a good team this year, has really struggled. But again, that could be a really good matchup at the beginning of the year. That was a game that we were really circling on Notre Dame's calendar this back-to-back week, USC against North Carolina, back-to-back games. So I think that'd be a fantastic thing to see if they can continue to win. Kentucky finds themselves with one loss playing Mississippi State. Mississippi State played very well. You're going to get all the weird questions about candy bars and goblins and everything to Mike Leach just because you know he'll answer it. Candy wrappers or whatever else they were asking him questions about. The guy is an absolute hilarious interview in my mind. The guy, I don't know how to take that guy, if he's serious or not, but the guy knows offensive football a little bit, and the guy knows some defensive football a little bit, and this is a really unique situation going down there with the cowbell. And then Wake Forest had probably the weirdest game of the whole weekend with playing Army and beating them 70-56, and the fact that Army had allowed that many points, one, is crazy, and allowed the fact that that game was so close at times was just really wild. A&M with a big win. They have two losses, so they're that best two-loss team. Oklahoma State with a huge loss. Oh my gosh, Iowa State. But Iowa State's the team that everybody expected at the beginning of the year to be the real team in the Big 12 and be at least a team to compete with Oklahoma at the end of the year, which they still might be able to do, right? You've got Baylor. Baylor has a bye, but Baylor's sitting there at 6-1. They're playing Texas next week. If they beat Texas, they're sitting there at 7-1, looking at a good opportunity. I think that's when they play Oklahoma. That could be a heck of a game. I think that's at Baylor. Pittsburgh continues to win, beating Clemson. Who would have thought that at the beginning of the year when we thought Clemson was going to be so good and continue their run, and they're getting beat by 10 by Pittsburgh. You know, Auburn, we talked about. Penn State, we talked about. They have to play. They took another loss. That was one of the craziest games of all time, a 9 overtime game. I mean, who would have ever drawn that up? I mean, it looked like a baseball scoreboard out there. I mean, that is just a crazy situation. The fact that there were so many of them that were stopped, that was the craziest thing. So just a really wild deal there in that game. San Diego State continues to win. They're at 7-0. It's going to be an interesting thing if they continue to go undefeated. And then UTSA, the other one that's undefeated. And then BYU finds them way in there. Coastal Carolina lost on the Thursday night, or on the whenever the heck that game was, Tuesday night or something. To App State, that was kind of the first shakeup of the week. But just a wild season this year, and super fun time to be a college football fan. So thank you guys for watching Sports Chat 503. We'll see you guys next week. Adios.